So now I'm going to go ahead and talk about how people feel about risk. And that's the idea of risk aversion. Aversion means you want to avoid something. So the idea here is that people dislike risk. And that may be just sort of common sense. But economists, of course, are going to make a graph out of this and maybe make common sense more complicated than it needs to be. And one way of thinking about risk aversion is the idea of thinking about someone's utility or happiness as it depends upon either their consumption or their wealth or their income. I'm going to go ahead and think about it in terms of their consumption. And it probably makes sense that, say, the first $10,000 per year of consumption, you know, that gets you off the streets, and that gets you a pretty high level of increase in your happiness. So your utility is like your happiness, and your first $10,000 gets you from zero happiness up to some significant positive level of happiness. And the next $20,000, okay, you can stop eating dog food. And so that is a significant increase in your happiness, but not as big. So big increase in happiness associated with your first $10,000, somewhat smaller increase in happiness associated with your second $10,000. And, you know, if you have another $10,000 worth of income, then you can actually afford a car, say, for instance. So still smaller increase in your happiness, and so on and so forth. So if this is true, then what we're talking about is a situation where you have decreasing marginal utility of consumption in this case. It could be decreasing marginal utility of wealth or decreasing marginal utility of income. So decreasing marginal utility. And again, marginal, remember, means incremental. Utility is happiness. So each incremental $10,000 gives you a smaller incremental benefit in terms of your happiness. So if that's true, then let's suppose we think about someone who currently has $20,000 worth of consumption. And let's suppose they face a 50-50 chance of either gaining $10,000 or losing $10,000. If that's true, you can see that sort of the gain on the upside is less than the loss on the downside. So this person won't like that. And in fact, we can sort of try and get an actual estimate of how much they will dislike it. Their average level of happiness, if they face that uncertainty, is actually halfway between this point and this point here. So for them, it looks like facing this gamble of 50% chance of $10,000 and 50% chance of $30,000 is like getting, say, $15,000. They would rather get $15,000 with 100% probability than face this 50-50 gamble between $10,000 and $30,000. So they're willing to pay to avoid the uncertainty. So another way of saying that would be, they would be willing to pay $5,000 to avoid this coin flip between plus $10,000 and minus $10,000. So this is one way of thinking about how people are risk averse. What we would notice if we sort of keep on delving into this is, well, this curve is curved, it's not straight, and the more swiftly this thing curves, and the less straight it is, the more risk-averse someone is. So another way of saying that is a curvier curve means marginal utility is decreasing more rapidly. So if this thing is steep at first and then very rapidly gets flat, you can see that the slope is decreasing. And that's going to mean that quickly the benefits of additional income are wearing out for this person, and that's going to mean they're more highly risk averse. So a curvier curve is more risk averse. Depending upon the particular way in which this utility function looks, it's also plausible that risk aversion is higher at lower levels of income than it is at higher levels of income. And I think intuitively that makes sense, because if you have a lower level of income, then you can't afford to lose this downside as much as someone maybe with a higher level of income. So you would actually be willing to pay more to avoid it, even though you actually have a lower level of income, because the downside is just so much worse for you. You know, if you're at $20,000, then, you know, if you lose $10,000, then you're going to go ahead and, you know, lose your apartment, but you'll still have enough to eat, maybe. If you're at just $10,000 worth of income, and you lose $10,000, well, now you've got nothing, and, you know, it's really hard to find anything to eat at all. Okay, so we have risk aversion. Risk-averse people dislike uncertainty. But risk-averse people like making money. So, if a risk-averse person has an investment opportunity that makes money on average, but exposes them to some probability of losing money, they'll be a little bit torn. Really highly risk-averse people might go, you know what, even though this investment makes money on average, there is some probability of losing money, so I dislike it, and therefore I don't take it. Other risk-averse people would go, you know what, I dislike the fact that I might lose money, but there's a lot of upside potential here, and I'm not super risk-averse, so I'm going to go ahead and make that investment. So again, risk aversion is not infinite. The fact that people dislike risk doesn't mean that's the only thing they care about. A lot of us dislike getting up in the morning, but we also care about keeping our jobs, so we manage to get up in the morning. Or a lot of people, you know, dislike having to exercise, but there are a lot of health benefits to that, and it makes you feel good after you actually get through it, so you're likely to actually do it. So again, people dislike uncertainty, but if there are other benefits that come along with the uncertainty, they may be willing to tolerate the risks.